I'm Tall Bike Tommy, this is Community TV, and welcome to my YouTube channel where I talk about things about my life. And sometimes that involves news stories of the locale in which I reside, which is Southern Alberta, specifically Medicine Hat. Sometimes I like to talk about what's going on in Calgary, if there's something interesting. You know, they're only about a 2.5 hour drive away, and what's going on in my day today? The first thing that happened today is I heard a bang on the window while I was working here, and I thought, geez, that was loud, kind of freaked me out a little bit, and I peeked out the window, and there was actually a little old lady there. I went outside, and she seemed a little bit confused, and she said she was lost, and, I'm in an area of town where there's an old folks' home just about 5 or 6 blocks away, and she said that's where she was looking for, that was her home. And, I said, well, it's back that way, and if you want me to give you a drive over, I can. And she offered me money, and I said, no way, I can't take your money. I'll drive you back over there. And I talked to her, and she told me who her son is, who's a local business owner here, somebody who I got in touch with. And, it was an interesting start to the morning, and I'm glad to have met a new friend. She invited me to come for lunch at the old folks' home. I think I might do that soon. And I asked her maybe if she'd want to be in one of my movies, and she said maybe. So, you know, we'll have to discuss that over lunch at some point. What else is new in my life, in Tom's life today? Well, I've received a couple of calls, from, you know, the guy, I guess, so he used to be, yeah, he had started with the original founders, this thing called the Canadian Combat Coalition. And I guess their sort of main purpose was to defend freedom of speech for Canadians. And most of the time, it seemed like they were defending the freedom of speech for groups like the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam. And I guess there was a little bit of infighting and some fractures happened there. And the guy, Ryan Dean, who started the Worldwide Coalition, Ryan Dean, who started Canadian Combat Coalition, was unceremoniously booted out of his own group. They didn't want to have anything to do with him because I guess he took some of the donation monies. They were trying to raise donations for different things, and he took some of that donation money for himself and spent it on his rent, is what I heard, allegedly. Okay? But, So anyways, this guy, Ryan, he started his own new thing, which is called the North American Freedom Fighters. I mean, there's so many of these alt-right groups out there just popping up all over the place. And, you know, it seems like most of the people who are the leaders of these groups are like scaredy cats and wingnuts and, you know, people that just want to preach hate and whatnot. But, you know, what they got going on this Sunday is this thing where, you know, I'd heard about the Deplorables Day. I saw one YouTube video where it said Worldwide Coalition Against Islam and 3C, Canadian Combat Coalition, would be in Calgary City Hall Sunday at maybe noon, 2 p.m., something like that. 2 p.m., I think. 1,400 hours. And they said that the whole reason for the event is to honor veterans. And I think any true patriotic Canadian would say that honoring veterans is a great thing to do. However, there's this possibility that they might try and basically stand on the backs of those veterans while screaming messages of hate. And that just does not leave a good taste in my mouth at all. Not one bit. Not one bit. I could just picture them now. You know what I mean? It's going to be a super small group. I mean, last time I was out there, I went up, for their June 27th, Patriotic Unity Mega Festival. And they said they were going to have, like, friggin' a pig roast and bouncy castles and a couple different bands doing great songs and performing live with big speakers and electric guitars. And Joey DeLuca said that his friend's band was going to be there and they're going to play the drums and guitars and sing in the microphones and play rock and roll music. But none of that happened. It ended up being basically about 25 people all wearing the same T-shirt, surrounded by police, gathering at City Hall with a couple of flags and screaming into the crowds. And I recorded quite a bit of it. It was an entertaining day, but I don't think there was really much patriotism shown. It kind of just annoyed most of the people in downtown Calgary that stopped to observe what they were doing. There's people out there that are saying like, Antifa, they're so bad. Like, they dress up in all black and they do terrible things. Like, I've seen some things on the news out of the United States where there are Antifa folks or, you know, anarchists that dress up in all black and they go places and, you know, just smash things and do crazy stuff. But just because somebody wears all black to a protest doesn't mean they're all in the same group. So I think you're really oversimplifying things if you say that anybody that wears all black anywhere near a protest is part of a group that's going to cause damage. I think that's an oversimplification, just like it's an oversimplification to say that every single person that's showing up for that rally is a white supremacist. They might not specifically be a white supremacist themselves. they might be, I don't know, I guess what you'd call white supremacy ally, maybe, or something like that. But, you know, a lot of the people that show up to these rallies, they have, you know, their own ideas about why the rally is happening and what's going on there, whether it be honoring veterans, whether it be, you know, defending freedom of speech. You know, it's a very general term. Sometimes that's used, sort of a coded language that's used to you know, help out in hosting these events and getting more people to come to them without truly realizing what it's all about sometimes. So, you know, you'll get those messages. You know, you'll also have, but the, you know, it being very blatant as well, the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam. They don't hide it at all. I mean, they're right in the name. It says they're against Islam. So, you know, there's it's problematic. And different people join these groups to go and speak there, like a local here, Sheldon Johnston. He recently went to the LGBTQ Safe Space Coffee House gathering, and he wore a T-shirt that said, "Jesus is King," and then on the back it said, "Jesus make Canada great again." And he proposed to be there to be discussing the health issues of people who have autism and the transgender. And he really relates these things and seems to have some ideas about how these things should be discussed at the same time and how they are related. I'm not sure if he's a physician, so I don't really exactly know everything about this, but maybe you'd want to ask Sheldon Johnston about this. Well, he's got some, you know, I guess, messages that he wants to bring publicly about what he believes. And I interviewed him not only at the coffee house down there and broadcast that in a previous video. I also have a lengthy phone call with him where we discuss a couple of other things, and I'll come up with that soon too. But Sheldon Johnston has said that he wants to go up to this rally, the Deplorables, with the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam and the Canadian Combat Coalition. And, you know, wow, it's like, what's going on in Canada? You know, I guess these guys tried to do a rally in Vancouver just recently, the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam and whatnot, and there was a Reddit post, which, you know, I might attach with this or post in the comments section, of Joey DeLuca, the leader of Worldwide Coalition Against Islam, actually showing up in Vancouver. So there were thousands of anti-racist protesters that were ready to basically rally against this group, and Joey DeLuca, the leader of this group, he showed up, and in the pictures he's wearing a blue shirt, which is very uncharacteristic for this guy who always tends to be wearing a red shirt. And I guess he stood outside of a restaurant where a few Reddit users were. They snapped a couple of pictures of him. These guys said, "Yeah, take all the pictures you want," and, you know, they went outside, took a few pictures, and then walked away. But basically, the leader of the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam did show up in Vancouver, but did not march anywhere. And then there was, you know, posts later, which you'll see through the Reddit link that I'll share with you, that also include screen captures of where it looks like on Facebook, Joey DeLuca was posting about having wasted his time on a 15-hour bus ride to go all the way to Vancouver for nothing. So yeah, you know, they're gonna come back to Calgary this Sunday because, you know, they felt that defeat in Vancouver and they think, you know what, we've got to rally the troops, we've really got to get together. But it also looks like the anti-fascist movement of Calgary, that's one of these groups that dresses up in all black, and they fight against fascism. And so they are proposing that these groups that are coming, like the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam and the other alt-right groups, they propose that these groups are fascist groups, and that we should fight against fascism. That's what Antifa is proposing, anti-fascist. So Calgary Anti-Fascist has this thing on their Facebook page where they're saying, we're having a rally, and it looks like there's way more people going to that rally than the Worldwide Coalition Against Islam Deplorables rally. So, you know, a guy like Sheldon Johnston, locally here from Medicine Hat's gonna go up there, and, you know, maybe we'll get some footage of that, who knows. I haven't quite decided if I'm gonna go up to the rally yet, so I guess maybe in the comment section, let me know if you want me to go up there. They've said they're gonna kill me, so it might be interesting. Thanks so much for watching Community TV, folks. Have a great day.